Welcome to the official Konami game tape. You'll learn how to clean up the swamps in Bayou Billy. How to score big in Blades of Steel. The way to beat Dracula in Castlevania. And tips on all 12 sports in track and field too. This game player's strategy tape is full of hints, tips, and playing strategies. To get the most from this tape, we suggest you first read the manual that comes with the cartridge and also have some experience playing the game. Good luck from the editors and game players at Game Players Magazines. Kicks are both quick and powerful. Use them here and stay in the corner. This marsh is filled with ferocious alligators. Avoid them by walking in a zigzag pattern to the other side. One of these guys forgot to bring his rock. When you get a chance, go ahead and kill him first. Also, don't overlook the ugly stick. It's a valuable weapon. Move over to this tree and you've got it made. The ugly stick works well against alligators too. Stand close to the water's edge with your back to the bank. Two of these divers carry guns with their scuba gear. Use your kicks to disarm them. Try out your new pistol on Hurricane Hank. Down in the swamp, take no prisoners. Shoot them all. There's no telling what weapons and items they'll leave behind. Now you're being attacked by ground snipers and an airborne whirlybird. First things first, take care of the snipers before you go after the chopper. After you give these Gator Alley boys a good thrashing, treat yourself to some raw meat and watch your lifeline nearly double. If someone knocks the ugly stick out of your hand here, you can catch it without even moving. This corner is the safest place you can be. You should drop the ugly stick before tangling with Louis Torture. With him, the stick doesn't work as well as plain old punching. After you defeat him, go back and get the stick. The road to New Orleans has a lot of curves and a lot of danger. The curves are easy to handle, just keep to the inside. You can't dynamite a plane and blow up a car at the same time. Slow down until you've destroyed the aircraft, then speed up until the car is back in your sights. Avoid puddles in the road. They can slow you down. On the road again, this time on Superdome Drive, but the same basic rules of driving apply. In this stage, time should be your main concern. The clock's working against you, so try to stay at the maximum speed, 180 miles per hour. You'll find fewer hazards here than on the dirt road you drove before. It's still dangerous, though, and its many curves will test your skills. Stand behind these Cajun cutthroats while punching them. The more you crowd them, the less room they have to pull their knives. The same advice holds true for Migraine Mike. Stay in close to him, too. Migraine Mike is kind of a headache, but at least he leaves you some raw meat. These guys aren't only powerful, they also carry whips. Fight them one at a time. After you've beaten one, take his whip and use it on the other. More Cajun cutthroats. Surprise them with your new weapon. Your whip just isn't working on Blackie Blue. You might get better results by using his ugly stick against him. Another Blackie is wearing a bulletproof vest. Grab it and finish him off. Be glad you've got a gun down on Murderer's Row. You're sure gonna need it. Keep a sharp eye out for any gunmen hiding in the windows. The accelerator rides a motorcycle. Shoot him, and he may leave you some extra ammo. Only these two guards are keeping you out of the hitman's yard. Start with the little guy, Lightning Rod. Then gear up for Schwarzenegger. A pistol would come in handy right about now. And all of these guys carry guns. A few kicks from you might loosen their grips. Fight them separately. Start with a whip and knock off their bulletproof vests. Now you can shoot them with your new pistol. These attack dogs look tough, but it's their trainer you need to worry about first. Once he's gone, you'll be surprised how easy it is to get rid of the dogs. You've made it all the way to the parlor of Gordon's plantation. Go to the bottom right corner and let him come to you. When he does, start jumping and kicking. It's the moment of truth. It's just you and Gordon. Or is it? If you like this game tape, you'll love Game Player's Pro Tip Hotline. Now you can hear the tips you want to know just by pushing a button on your telephone.
To hear this tip again, press 1. For another game tip, press 2. For our classic tips, press 3.
Each week, our Game Player's experts choose the best hints and tips for 3 hot games for the Nintendo Entertainment System. Just dial and select which secrets you want to hear. Every week, we'll change the games and the hints. Try it today. Before starting a tournament, try a few games of exhibition play to sharpen your skills. Now, let's look at a tournament. Select the league play that's right for your skills. Your chances are good in the junior league, but it takes the hottest players to take the tourney in the college and pro leagues. You'll want to experiment with different teams to see which one has the right combination of strength, speed, and finesse that will win you the cup. We'll go with New York here. To capture the cup, you'll have to win a 3-round tournament against some tough competition. New York starts off against Minnesota. At the opening face-off, use rapid fire if you have it, or hit the B button as quickly as possible to get the puck. Don't waste time. Start a charge for the goal as soon as you can. When defending your goal, the arrow shows where your opponent's shot will go, so follow it with your goalie to deflect the shot. Smooth passing will help you move the puck down the ice quickly and set you up for the score. When controlling the goalie, try to stay right in front of the puck so you can catch it. If you do, you can hold on to it until the coast is clear. But if the other goalie catches the puck, stick around to intercept it. You can see here how well that can work out. If you check the same opponent 3 times in a row, you'll have to throw some punches. Hit him fast so you'll knock him down, and then you can go for the puck. But if you're not quick enough, off come the gloves. Aim for his face, and this guy's headed for the penalty box. Try shots from different angles. Sometimes a chancy slap like this one will pay off. Don't let other players distract you when you're waiting for a clear shot. Stand in front of the goal, and when the arrow is clear, so are you. Keep an eye on the clock. There are 3 20-minute periods in every game, just like the real thing. By the way, don't put your controller pad down during the break. You can destroy the scoreboard spaceship while the players take a breather. Fire quickly and watch its patterns. Back on Earth, let's play some hockey. Speed is sometimes your best weapon. Move quickly, and there won't be time to check you or to block you. Don't fall asleep. When the other team suddenly gets the puck, the worst can happen if you let down your guard. Your goalie has a blind spot on his far side. Be careful not to let a shot go there. Try to steal back the puck while you're still deep in your opponent's territory. If you're the goalie, watch who you pass the puck to. If an opponent is nearby, he could bump you and steal the puck. Watch your opponent before and after he passes. If you leave a spot open, the computer can take advantage of it. When attacking your enemy, get right in his face. You have no chance of stopping him from behind. If one of your shots is blocked, follow up by skating in quickly for another try. Don't give the other team an open spot on the ice, or they'll charge right through your defense. One key to winning in Blades of Steel is passing. You should pass the puck as much as you can, as fast as you can. Even though hockey is a rough-and-tumble game, you can get penalties for too much roughness. So play hard, but remember the rules. When you have the lead and only a little time, run out the clock by putting on your own ice show. During the tiebreaker scene, mix up your shots to confuse the goalie. Keep watching him to decide whether to shoot high or low. On the other hand, if you're the goalie, you should be watching the puck the whole way. This time, New York faces off against Edmonton. Use these tips when you play Blades of Steel, and you'll be the one they call Fire on Ice.
Where'd you get your hands on Konami's new video game? Starring me, that raging cager. By your belly pin, for the first time ever, Konami combines hand-to-hand combat with driving, shooting, and of course, zapping. In one swamp, stomping adventure.
The Adventures of Bayou Billy for Nintendo.
It all starts when I get out this here swamp. You really getting me riled now.
Make the panther come to you. And anytime you fight one of these cats, keep your distance. There's a money bag waiting for you on the right side of each column. This cross will clean your enemies off the screen. You can refill your energy by finding the pork chop hidden behind this wall. Make some easy money by smashing the block on the far right. Hop down to the platform below and wait for the bag to appear. Take a whiff to one of these candles and you'll find the axe. You'll need it to destroy the first head creature. A phantom bat. Grab the double shot from the brick below you. get back on top, and start throwing weapons at him. Break out a section of this wall and go inside the space you've made. A crown worth 2,000 points will appear at the bottom of the stairs. You can always use a double shot, and there's one tucked away down here. Step right up. Another pork chop is down here. If you're not too full, here's some more food. With good timing, you can avoid a really big problem. Run under the first people presser, then stop. Duck underneath the second, then hurry under the third. Don't stop to enjoy the beauty of this statue. It won't last long. To kill the head of Medusa, keep whipping it from a distance. Kneeling down here will make a money bag appear. This dragon skull cannon is a fierce opponent, but the morning star you found has strengthened your whip. Double your weapons when fighting these mummy twins. Use your whip while you throw daggers at them. You can finish them off faster by hitting them when they're together. Keep your head down while moving under the spikes, or they'll knock you off. Also, watch out for bats. To get through this area, you must keep going. Don't stop unless a hunchback is about to fall on you. Whip him just before he lands, or he'll try to pounce on you. If you jump quickly enough, you can get behind the Skele-Dragon. Then it's easy to kill him and load up on hearts. You can turn Frankenstein into a quick victory. Move in close and burn him up with your firebombs. The Axemen have razor-sharp blades, but no courage. Move towards them and they'll back off the screen. As soon as you uncover this double shot, you can really rain trouble on the Axeman below you. Better grab this boomerang. You're going to have a tough time later without it. Pray that this pork chop isn't your last meal. Get this double shot and the hidden triple shot. You'll need all the help you can get to beat the Grim Reaper. Stay on the left and wait for him to come closer. Hit him with every boomerang you can. Thank you. Just walk past the first two bats. Freeze the third one by using the clock and the candle. Jump over the fourth bat and run under the last one. Make a run for the stairs on the left, but be careful. Hunchbacks may try to bump you off. Welcome to Dracula's crypt. To defeat him, you'll need to get in close and jump the fire he shoots. At the exact moment he strikes, hit him with a whip. Your sense of timing is crucial. If you can kill Dracula, consider yourself lucky. But be prepared for other surprises, too. Here are some bonus tips to improve your skills in Castlevania. When you start to go into a doorway, you'll be pulled in the rest of the way. When you get to the left side of the door, hop over to the right. Doing this will cause a money bag to appear over here. In Castlevania, parts determine how many times you can use one of your special weapons. Don't pass up any chance to collect more hearts. You'll really need them when you get to the head creature. Take your time as you maneuver over the platforms. If you rush, you could lose your footing and fall to your death. In most fantasy adventure games, time isn't working against you anyway. If you climb the stairs quickly here, the skeleton will just hop over you without harming you. But if you hesitate, he'll start throwing bones at you, and you'll have a hard time making the stairs. In most fantasy adventure games, there are some general rules to follow. First, take some time to explore the area you're in. You may find useful weapons or money. Also, talk to everyone you can. You never know what you might learn. These games contain a lot of information. You may want to take notes on what you discover. Finally, don't be afraid to use the pause button. Sometimes it may be the best friend you have.
It's the number one bet. It's got no wise, it's a one to get. Arcane action is where you'll be. Yeah, Freedom Stick will set you free. No wires! It works with Sega, Nintendo too. With Atari, Commodore, it's real cool. Higher scores is what you'll see. Cause Freedom Stick will set you free. No wires!
If you enjoyed this great game tape, you'll really enjoy Game Players Magazine. Every exciting issue is packed full of hints, tips, and playing strategies, just like the ones on this game tape. You can order a dream subscription to both Game Players Guide to Nintendo Games and Game Players Magazine, a total of 18 awesome issues today for only $39.95. Don't miss another issue. If you want to play to win, call now. Our operators are ready. Remember, this number is for subscription orders only. The dream subscription for Nintendo game players. The main thing to remember during the fencing competition is to block your opponent's sword. Here we're playing against the computer. He's on the right. Watch how we hold him off by blocking at first, then moving in to score points by touching him with the sword. Only the third jump counts in this event, but the first two jumps must be good or the third one will be short. Follow this pattern. Run as fast as you can. Then go medium high on the first jump, as high as possible on the second, then medium high on the last jump. Do the butterfly stroke. It's fastest. Hit the A, then B buttons back and forth as fast as you can. And as in most of the events in track and field too, if you use a controller with rapid fire, you'll have a real advantage. Here, we're using rapid fire, and it's no contest. You're judged on grace, beauty, and speed. Try to perform difficult dives, including as many flips and jackknives as possible before you hit the water. Also, be as straight as you can when entering the water. A perfect 10 score is rare in this event, and rapid fire won't help you at all here. Press button B to send a clay pigeon into the air. Take your time. You control when the targets shoot up the screen, so you can be ready each time. Then keep your eyes on the gray launch area in the middle of the screen. You'll be able to tell which direction the next target heads into the sky. You've got to have quick reflexes and try to get the target in your sights before firing. You only get two shots per target. Get as much on the power meter as you can, then let it go at a high angle. Rapid fire isn't any help here, but a joystick is better than a power pad for this event. Here's a good trick. Normally, you'd want to work the power meter up to maximum, but try keeping it just below the O and the word power. When he starts flashing, hold down the A button until the hammer is thrown. Even though you hardly threw the hammer anywhere, you'll be amazed at the great score you earned. Of all the moves you can choose in this event, stick with combinations of roundhouse kicks and jumping kicks. They're the most powerful and the most damaging techniques. Work your way in close with the jump kicks. Then when you get your chance, one or two roundhouses will usually finish him off. Let's watch this technique in action as our expert on the left triumphs in this match. Yeah. For best results, put the tip of your pole exactly in the center of the square in front of the bar, and use rapid fire if you have it to gain maximum speed before the jump. It's important to learn the order of the flags in this contest. You have to get to the finish line as fast as you can, but you must go through all of the flags, and in the right order. If the flags are white, go right on through. And watch out for flag number 4. You have to ignore it until you get through flag number 3 first. If a flag is marked R, you have to go through it backwards. R means reverse. Flag 7 has a slash mark, and that means you have to go through it from the downstream side. This is one of the harder events, so practice it before you enter the official Olympics. That way you'll learn how to move around and which flags are special. And stay away from the banks of the stream as much as you can. They'll slow you down. At the end, your score is tallied by combining speed with how many flags you pass successfully. Check the wind first. If it's blowing from behind you, don't use as much power, but use more power if you're shooting into the wind. When the pointer under wind on the bottom of the screen points upward, that means that the wind is blowing from right to left. When this happens, divide the wind figure in half to get your aim. For example, if it's blowing 6 to the left, then you should aim 3 to the right. For the 70-meter target, aim the bow upwards between 05 and 06. And for the 90-meter target, aim up at 08 and give it full power.
Mark.
The trick here is getting a good start without jumping the gun. Practice until you really know the announcer's rhythm well and can lunge exactly when the gun goes off. Also, use rapid fire if you've got it. In this event, as in the diving event, you get more points if you show a variety of moves. Also, you'll have time to perform each move more than once, but you shouldn't do the same move twice in a row. Mix them up, and remember to keep going as fast as you can. Here's a tip about dismounting. Wait until your gymnast lets go of the bar, then you let up on all of the buttons on your controller. That will get you a perfect landing every time.